Hello everyone, welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. With this video I want to show you a nice solution for one of the more common problems with landscape photography, which is over or underexposure. And that's just because your camera's dynamic range isn't big enough to get all the information from the highlights or the shadows, and that's especially true during sunsets or sunrises. So usually I would use Lightroom's HDR tool or even a specialized Photoshop plugin to do this, but in this video, however, I want to show you a third way which will get you very natural results, very fast and very easy. So let's jump into it. If you want to prevent under or overexposure in very contrast rich scenes like this one, we most definitely need to blend multiple exposures together. So here you can see the exposure for the sky. I have all the details in the sky up there, but the problem, of course, you can see it already, is there isn't any detail in the foreground left, and that just looks not that nice. Therefore, we do have this brighter shot. You can see the sky is blown out, but we do have some very nice detail in the foreground, which is exactly what we want. And in this video, I'm going to use the Apply Mask tool in Photoshop to blend those two images together by simply doing a few mouse clicks. If you're just here for this method, then check the video chapters down below. But first off, I will need to do some base adjustments for this image. So let's go right here with the darker exposure first. Very important here, I want to remove the chromatic aberration since there is quite a bit of this in this image. Then let's change the profile to Adobe Landscape since I want this image to be saturated. And I also want the sky to be very warm and give a nice sunset feeling, so I'm going to change the white balance to cloudy. Nice. Since we're blending two images to get the perfect exposure, I don't really need to adjust anything here. However, I do want to make sure the highlights are good for the darker exposure, so I'm going to drop them very slightly. Alright, then let's add a little bit of texture. And I want to have a soft look over this image, so I'm dropping the clarity as well, just a bit. And then let's introduce some vibrance. Okay, nice. Now to keep this video simple, I don't want to introduce any local adjustments. Let's just do a little bit of color grading. And I want to further work on this sunset look in the tone curves panel. In the red channel, I'm just boosting the point for the highlights a little bit to the left, and that looks awesome. So no need for the color mixer, but I want to do some split toning, and again for the highlights, I just want to have this nice warm color tone. I think I want to go more into the red range, but the saturation looks good. And for the shadows, I want to apply a cold color tone real quick. And let's bring down the saturation here. All right. And of course, I want to sharpen this image a bit. All right. That looks really good. Now that we have the adjustments for the sky exposure, of course, we want to have the same settings on the base image, which is the brighter exposure. So I'm holding down the shift key, click on the thumbnail of the other image, then right click, synchronize settings, check all and hit OK. Now let's switch over to the bright one real quick. As you may remember, I dropped the highlights in the darker exposure, which I want to undo for this shot. Instead, here the shadows are more important, so I'm going to raise them in order to have a nicely exposed foreground later. But that's it for the raw adjustments. Now let's go on with the fun part. Again, I'm selecting both of them and just hit open. To do the exposure blending, we want to use the brightest image as our base image and the darker one as a layer on top of it. So that means we're going to the dark exposure, hit Ctrl A to select everything, and then just copy this image by hitting Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Right away, you can see the images aren't aligned perfectly because I was shooting handheld, as my tripod was already in use. So let's align them real quick. Therefore, I can select both of the layers go to Edit and just hit Auto Align Layers and hit OK. Now you can see they are perfectly aligned. I just need to crop the image a little bit, so I'm hitting C. And let's take away a little bit from the left. This area isn't interesting anyway. To blend those two images, we want to use a layer mask on the dark layer. So with this layer selected, I'm simply hitting the layer mask icon down here. And now, very important, we want to turn off this darker layer. So Photoshop picks up all the luminance information from the brighter exposure below. Then for the next step, besides making sure you have turned off the darker exposure, you also want to select the layer mask. Therefore, you just click on the layer mask right here. And now let's go to Image. And here we are choosing Apply Image. There are a bunch of settings you can play around with, but for the purpose of the exposure blending, just leave it at those settings and hit OK. And as you can see, this basically fills the layer mask with a black and white version of the photo. So if you alt-click on the layer mask, you can see the brighter areas like the sky are becoming more white, while the foreground is filled with a darker gray or even black color tone. And since this is applied on our layer mask, if we turn on the darker exposure again, you can see we have nicely blended those two images. We have a brighter foreground while there isn't any overexposure in the sky. Now you might even want to repeat this step and make the layer mask just a little more accurate. And that's pretty easy. Just again, turn off the darker exposure, make sure to select the layer mask, and just repeat the apply image step again. Just hit OK. And now we do have a really nice layer mask. And this is already looking really good, but of course you can always adjust the layer mask manually. So for this example, let's make it visible once more by alt-clicking on it. One thing I like to do is to use the brush tool, change the mode of it to overlay, and let's drop the opacity a bit. Okay, now I want to introduce some more contrast between the foreground and the sky. So if I'm using white with the overlay blending mode and paint over the sky, only the brighter pixels are affected by the white brush. You can see if I paint over this statue on the right, it won't change much. And this just means I can get more of the darker sky blended together with the bright foreground of the base exposure. So I just continue to brush over this. And at this point, I can just go out of this layer mask. And to get a nice blend, I'm just painting over this image like this. Maybe I do want to have a brighter reflection in the water. That means I need to mask out the area from the darker exposure. Therefore, I'm going with black as the foreground color. And then let's just carefully brush over the foreground. All right. And this way we can get very natural exposure blending done in Photoshop. So that's it for the tutorial. Still, I want to finish the post-processing for this shot, so feel free to stay and let's continue. As we are done with the exposure blending, I want to merge those two images, so I'm selecting both layers and hit Ctrl E. And now let's first clean up this shot. So I want to duplicate that layer just in case I mess something up. Therefore, I'm pressing Ctrl J. Let's select the lasso tool right here and just make a rough selection for this flagpole. Okay, and now I'm hitting Shift F5 and you can see I have the content aware method selected. So let's hit OK. That looks perfect. Now I do think I want to get rid of this bright light as well. So again, I'm just using the lasso tool to make a rough selection here. And again, Shift F5 and hit OK. Nice. Then maybe this thing as well. Oh. Okay, and then we do have some kind of crane in the back. There, I'm just using the spot healing brush and roughly paint over it, and it's gone. Nice. Alright, next up, let's introduce a little bit of glow. Therefore, I'm creating a new layer and let's switch the blending mode to soft light. And I'm picking up the brush tool by pressing B and let's bring down the brush opacity. And I'm picking up a color tone from this bright area in the sky right there by holding down the Alt key and clicking in here. That looks pretty good. Now let's just paint in a little bit of glow here. Okay, I don't want to overdo it, so that should be enough, I guess. And again, I want to merge those layers. And then finally, let's take a look at the Nick Collection plugin. First off, let's go with the polarization effect to make the colors look a little nicer. Just turn up the strength a bit. Okay, let's see. I think I want to add another filter. And this time I'm choosing the Glamour Glow for this soft, dreamy look. Just want to introduce some more warmth to the glow. And let's bring back a little bit of saturation. But that looks pretty good. I do think I want to have some sharpness in there left, so I'm adding a negative control point just around here. And let's maybe add another one around here. Alright, nice. Then let's apply it like this. Okay, and at this point I'm done with editing. So I hope this tutorial was interesting, as well as the other part of the post-processing. If you have any questions left, feel free to ask it in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.